Well, many of us have family traditions like celebrating the start of Passover. Handing down jewelry and other collectibles is also a tradition in many families, and sometimes we prefer to pass those items on.
That's right, and we know a guy who'd like to buy your items for cash, Neil Sechmer of Nevada Coin Mart, joining us today alongside Rabbi Shuhatz of Chabad, East Las Vegas.
Yay!
Dave, as the days go on in these segments, I become more and more Jewish.
I don't think I did a first
this is the best time we ever did it, right?
I'm getting there.
Are we going to get him a yarmulke at some point?
Yes. Well, I'm ready. Soon. That's coming up.
Passover, you know, it's also coming up, April 19th. Explain what Passover represents for those who don't know.
So Passover starts April 19th. It's a holiday of 8 days. We celebrate when about 3,000 years ago, the Jews left Egypt, the exodus from Egypt. They were slaves in Egypt by Pharaoh. And then through Moses and the miracle of the 10 plagues, as we all know. So then the Jews finally left Egypt to receive the Torah on Mount Sinai. So this is a holiday that is celebrated as the most popular Jewish holiday celebrated by all Jews, that we sit and we have the Passover Seder, to the Passover dinner, to tell the story of Exodus and to celebrate with the kids. So we eat the famous matzah, which is flat bread, because when the Jews left Egypt, they didn't have time to bake the bread, that the bread should rise. Mm-hmm. So that's why it's like flat bread. It comes also to teach us that we have to be more humble people and we shouldn't have ego, you know? So that's the idea of the matzah. So we celebrate freedom, and of course, we always like to celebrate among everybody in the community. Everybody should feel the holiday. So thanks to Neil and Nevada Coin Mart, we make a dinner at the synagogue, a Passover dinner for 150 people. Mm-hmm. So I would like to thank Neil again for sponsoring the dinner and helping out with it. Everybody is welcome to join.
Yeah. Boy, he makes it sound very fun, doesn't he? The whole holiday.
And they have the Afikoman, right?
Yeah. What's the
Afikoman. That was like the greatest time we were growing up, because what happens is when you're all sitting around, who's ever the head of the table, they take a napkin and they put money in there or whatever, and then they go and hide it. And then everybody's supposed to go around and find.
Something tells me Neil found it.
Yeah, of course.
We hide the matzah. Yeah. And then we had a piece of matzah, and then afterwards the kids look for it. Then whoever finds it gets a gift.
There we go.
Oh,
right.
Fun.
That was the greatest.
Come on, now I remember.
Right, of course.
And this is part of your continued tradition at Nevada Coin Mart of giving back to the community.
Sure. No. So the thing is that I love the intro. You know, it was fantastic about the passing down of things, because a lot of people do pass down, you know, certain items to their family members. And this is one of the time in the Jewish religion where, you know, you do get together with the family and it's like, oh, you know, this is Aunt Susie's ring, or, you know what I mean? These type of things, because it's more of a bonding moment.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so we're there if somebody does want to cash in or whatever. But when it comes to the community, you know, it's very important. There are a lot of things in the world that are not legitimate. And so when it comes to the legitimacy of the rabbi and his organization, it's one of the things that I love, because you don't have to look beyond that to see if there's something that's not correct, or is there something fishy going on. And the answer is no. And so it's tremendous. Every single holiday, he's always doing so many wonderful things for the community for free, out of his own graciousness, of his own heart. And so it's really the feeling of mutual, because I just enjoy hanging out with him and doing all these things and being a supporter of everything that he does, because it's really tremendous.
So the rabbi mentioned all the traditions that he will be practicing around Passover and, the things he enjoys. I didn't know that about the matzah, by the way, that it represented being humble. We should all eat some more matzah. Sean, especially
some
you
more
and I.
Than others.
Yeah. But what are some of the traditions that you love the most? Well, you mentioned the hiding of the money. Yes.
Right. And so one of the things that I always remember growing up is that we did have the Seder plate, and it was always the different pieces. You know, you had the lamb and like the horseradish and these type of things. And I didn't enjoy everything, but it was more about, you know, you're there with the family.
Yeah.
This type of environment is the same type of environment that we hope to all achieve later on in life, or however it is.
Yeah.
And so we're always spending time with the family and making sure that, you know, everything is really humble in itself.
Now, I know the rabbi would prefer you were closed on Saturdays. Would prefer that you were closed on Passover.
Yes, this is
but you are Always. Oh, every day.
Naughty boy.
365.25, I'm counting the leap years.
Yes.
Days a year.
Yes.
Open.
Soon to be 365, yes, next year, because it's the leap year.
66.
66, right. 366.
Wow.
And so that'll be the new commercials.
Can but, you take the leap day off?
Why don't you
that
do that?
Every leap
that, 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 that could be an interesting
one day
thing.
Every 4 years.
But here's
yeah.
the thing. Everybody wants to come in. They want to laugh. They want to joke. And they want to see me. They want to know that the person that they see on the TV is actually the guy that is going to help them.
Yeah.
And so it's very important. You know, there's a lot of different places all over town that do buying and selling of all different types of products. And so they want to see the guy that's on TV, and they want to make sure that he's there. And that's why when we buy any type of jewelry, Rolexes, diamonds, anything like this, we want to ensure that I'm there so that I can make the final decision to always give the very best price.
No question. Neil, it's great having you.
Yeah, thanks.
Thank you.
Okay, happy thanks. Passover. Happy Passover.
Happy Passover to everyone. Hey, receive top dollar for your stuff at Nevada Coin Mart. You can call them or visit the website, jonesandflamingo.com. That's their exact location on the map. Nevada Coin Mart, a proud sponsor of Las Vegas Morning Blend, and they are a proud supporter of organizations such as Chabad East Las Vegas. You missed anything on Las Vegas Morning Blend this morning? Don't you worry. We get them all on our website.
That's right. Even Sean's email. You can go back and get that. We post videos from the past 3 months. So if you missed anything, just head there. We'll be right back.